5 productivity websites. These are ones that I've discovered along my way, and I wanted to get you started with them and help you on. These are a little bit different because they're just websites you can go to instead of necessarily downloading a specific application for it. So I hope you enjoy these recommendations. Before we begin, our sponsor today is Sanebox. Here's a little bit more about them.
Today's video is sponsored by Sanebox. It's great to have them back. And if you're looking to get that inbox all tidied and cleared, it is a great solution that's out there. So they've got 3 features that are pretty powerful and many more. Sane Later for helping you keep the important emails first. Black Hole for keeping those awful emails out of the way, and Sane Reminders for reminding you at the right time of certain emails. And the tool is really powerful and works with all clients and devices. It also gets some great shout outs there in the productivity community for keeping those emails away from your inbox and saving on users an average 3 to 4 hours a week. You can check out the discount below. Big thanks to Sanebox for sponsoring today's feature.
So number one is PomoFocus. Now PomoFocus has been around for some time, and it's a really neat little application for being able to start a Pomodoro timer. Sometimes people don't want to commit to buying or setting up a full Pomodoro timer, and they just want a web version. And this one's really neat for just that, if you're looking to implement the Pomodoro methodology. Next up is Coffitivity. I can't even say this. Coffitivity. Coffitivity. If you love the sound of coffee shops, that constant murr in the background of people talking, having a natter, sometimes a nat can be distracting. You can get into like accidentally listening into someone's conversation and being like, whoop, I shouldn't be doing this. But basically, this is a coffee shop library for you to hear sort of murmurs in the background. They do have a premium, but largely it's free and you can get started straight away. And if you just want to have that coffee shop feel background while you're at home, realizing that you're very lonely, maybe I've done it before, then this is a great application for that. Next up is WorldTimeBuddy. I'm always struggling with like time zones, and I always end up Googling like 5 p.m. ET to PBST, and I'm like, oh my God, this is a nightmare. There's an app called WorldTimeBuddy that you can just search for a place or time zone, and it does it like a linear match to the specific other areas, which is really nice because it doesn't be like, oh, okay, what time's that? And it helps you to more educate you over the years, so you don't necessarily have to always go to it. Like, you can relate to it. Okay, 11 a.m. is 12 p.m. in Cairo. But I recommend that one. And also, it does it per day, so it takes into account things like daylight savings as well, which is handy. Number 4 is Capterra. We've had Capterra on before, but basically they are a way for you to find productivity app reviews. I'm taking myself out of the job here, but Capterra helps you to search for ones that are pretty like widely known, like Todoist, Monday. And what it will do is it'll help you compare them using their compare feature. This is a great productivity website because you can see directly features. And this helps with the research of finding the right productivity app for you. So next up is Do Nothing for 2 Minutes. It's literally a website where it starts a timer if your mouse or keyboard aren't moving, and you can listen to the waves. And it's nice because you can just do nothing for 2 minutes, which is really cool. I mean, you could start a timer yourself, but I like the way that it forces you not to touch your mouse or else it will restart the timer. Really cool little site. Bit weird in a sense, because it's just like I never saw that in the corner there. It's developed by Calm. That totally makes sense for their branding, but Calm have developed it, so they're the meditation application. Anyway, folks, those are 5 applications that we could use for productivity. They're all free, and you can check them out in the link in the description. But I hope you found this video fun. If you're new here, please do hit subscribe. And thank you very much to Sanebox for sponsoring today's feature. I'll see you all very soon in our next video here on Keep Productive. Cheerio!